Good morning, and welcome to our all-school mass. Today we celebrate the feast of St. Francis Xavier Cabrini, and our celebrant for this mass is Father Fred. And let's take and worship together our opening song, The Sun.
Rejoice greatly to find some of your children walking in the truth, just as we were commanded by the Father. But now, Lady, I ask you, not as though I were writing a new commandment, but the one we have heard from the beginning. Love one another, for this is love, that we walk according to his commandments. This is the commandment, as you heard from the beginning, in which you should walk. Many deceivers have gone out into the world. Those who do not acknowledge Jesus Christ is coming in the flesh. Such is the deceitful one and the antichrist. Look to yourselves that you do not lose of what we work for, but may receive a full recompense. Anyone who is so progressive as to not remain in the teaching of Christ does not have God. Whoever remains in the teaching has the Father and the Son. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord. Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord. Blessed are they whose way is blameless, who walk in the law of the Lord. Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord. Blessed are they His decrees, who seek Him with all their heart. Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord.
That's a hard gospel reading. It's too much in her. but we'll make it simple. The people in this time, they were following. They were following the Lord God. They were kind of doing what they wanted to do. And they didn't take care of one another. They were only worried about themselves. And when you worry about yourself, what's that called? Do you know what that word is? What do you think? Go ahead, Steve. Can you hear it? Yeah, you can say it. See, let's hear it. What's the word when you just worry about yourself? What's it called?
And you say you don't care about anybody else but you.
You don't care about anybody else but you. And that's called, have you ever heard the word selfish? How many of you have heard the word selfish? Raise your hands. How about you in the classroom? Raise your hands. Have any of you heard the word selfish? St. Francis and Xavier Cabrini, she's got a lot of names. And she lived right here in Chicago. That's the cool part. And she wasn't selfish. And when the people came from Italy, were anybody Italian here today? Any Italian people? All right, there you go. When people came from Italy, she was a nun over in Italy, and then she came here to help the immigrants, those people who come from other countries. She helped the little children whose parents may have died and they had no family. She helped in schools. She helped the sick people in hospitals. So she wasn't selfish, was she? And St. Francis Xavier Cabrini, that's what Cabrini. Their name there, in case you didn't know. And so we have to follow her model so that when we grow up, it's just not about being rich and making money and being famous. You want to make enough because you can live on it. Why? It's more about following the commandment. And the greatest commandment in the first reading is love all your heart. How do you do that? You care about other people. So I'm going to ask you to think about one word today. And it's only four letters. And it begins with the word H. Can you guess what it is?
Help.
Help. If you don't remember anything else today, one word.
H-E-L-P.
Help. Help. H-E-L-P. Let's hear everybody spell.
H-E-L-P.
Help. That's what Jesus wants us to do. Help bring his love. And let us rise and offer our many prayers for people throughout the whole world, for people here in the United States of America, and all the people here in Oklahoma. So the first thing are the people in the world. Let us pray for all the people in the world who are trying really hard to put an end to the virus. Doctors, the scientists, the nurses. For them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us always remember, as we pray for the world needs, that we pray for our Pope Francis, who has so much to do because he has to take care of all the Catholics, even the Christians, and all people in the world, that he may always, you know, feel that love of Jesus that Jesus has for him, and that he may continue to spread that love by helping others. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray as a country that we may not be self-centered or selfish, that we may always help one another and bring people together to build a beautiful country. For this, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the people right here in our own neighborhood, let us pray for all of those people who may have the virus, silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Gracious and loving God, we thank you for this beautiful day. Help us to always be good helpers, to help one another. As we offer up our prayers for Christ our Lord, and so we say, amen.
Amen.
Now we join them with the angels and the saints to adore you. died, Jesus was having supper with his apostles. He took bread from the table and gave thanks and praise. He broke the bread and gave it to his apostles, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, he took the chalice that was filled with wine. He thanked you and gave it to his apostles, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." We now do what Jesus told us to do. We remember his death and resurrection, and we offer you, Father, the bread that gives us life and the cup that saves us. Jesus, bring us to you as we welcome him. Father, because you love us, you invite us to come to your table. Fill us with the joy of the Holy Spirit as we receive the body and blood of your Son. Lord, you never forget any of your children. We ask you to take care of those we love, especially our families. We pray for those who have died, especially all of our families from our school. We also remember our teachers and staff. Remember everyone who is suffering from pain or sorrow. Remember Christians everywhere and all other people in the world. We are filled with wonder and praise when we see what you do for us through Jesus, your Son.
Sins of the murderer.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him. Takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Thank you.
renewed by our partaking of this divine gift, we pray, O Lord our God, by the example of Blessed Francis and Xavier Cabrini, bearing in our body the death of Jesus, we may strive to hold fast to you alone. Through Christ our Lord, and so we say, Amen.
Amen.
So what's the word we're gonna think about and do today? It's the four-letter word. You remember? Let's hear everybody say it. Just say it out loud. So in an extra way, we can help one another as we honor St. Francis and Xavier Cabrini and how she helped people who are in need. We really need to help one another so that when you grow up, you can be really good at it. The peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you as we gather again in prayer. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Thanks be
to God.
Our closing song together is Go Out, Go Out.